So then you built the movie career, and again, people I think kind of you built it on comedy primarily. I mean, was that something at the point when you did Friends and you started all of that? I mean, were you looking for other things and they just weren't there, or were you was this a happy place for you to be, and so
I
you're just
was
happy to do
just in a
comedy?
happy place. I was getting, you have to understand, when you have nothing to compare it to, and you just get to go to work and you see so many of your friends who are not working. I'm just grateful to be working and doing movies that I found fun and entertaining, and some were beloved and some were not, and then it wasn't until I got really a lot started getting older where I realized, I think having done The Good Girl, it made me really sort of realize, oh, I have a choice of what I can do. I really can explore other things and not just sit back and just wait for what's handed to you. So I think I started back then being more conscious and vocal with my managers and agents about areas that I wanted to explore. And doing The Good Girl helped. Sorry, hitting my mic. Helped me in that way, because I think if you're, it's an industry that's very sort of, I can say you've done this before, so I will grant you the ability to do it again. And if you haven't done it, then it's like a kind of an insecure business, I think, in a lot of areas, especially in the higher ups or having an imagination of what would be interesting and creatively unexpected, you
Well, it
know?
takes a Miguel Arteta to
Yeah, it takes some, but I think
see
there's
out of the
something great
box.
about the younger filmmakers because they're not. They're that that's an exciting challenge to take someone who's sort of an established personality and put them knowing that they have a. I mean, thankfully he trusted that I could do that. For him, it was an exciting challenge.